Hello everyone, I'm Sid from Carnegie Mellon University. This talk is about applying transformer transducers in the context of code-switched speech recognition. This work was done during my internship at Amazon along with my collaborators Yuzong, Srikanth and Katrin from the AWS transcribe team at Amazon. This talk is outlined in three main parts where I will first discuss what is code switching and the challenges it presents in speech recognition. I will then talk about transformer transducer models and propose new training strategies that addresses the challenges discussed in the previous part. I will then discuss each of the proposed techniques in detail, followed by the overall results and the key takeaways. Okay, so let's start. Code switching is the phenomena where two or more languages are used by a speaker in a single conversation. It is predominant among the multilingual communities, which comprises of almost 60% of the world population. Code switching can occur either at an utterance level or within a single utterance. The latter is called intra-sentential code switching and is typically more challenging. The following are two examples of intra-sentential code switching between Spanish and English, where you see that en la masa and pollo are borrowed words from Spanish into English. We will discuss these examples in detail in the later slides. So, what are the challenges involved in building speech recognition systems for code switching? One major challenge is that the multilingual speech recognition research typically assumes input is from a native speaker and does not mix languages. This setup is quite impractical as these speakers are typically bilingual or even multilingual and continuously code switch between languages. This causes several challenges in both acoustics and language, like having different phone sets among languages, influence of native language in pronunciation, grammar from multiple languages in a single sentence, and finally, insufficient collection of code switch training data. More concretely, there are two kinds of intrasentential code switching called insertional code switching and alterational code switching. In insertional code switching, the structure and the grammar of the matrix language or the main language is maintained while inserting words from an embedded or secondary language. For example, in I don't want to eat my pollo, pollo can be easily replaced with chicken without any loss in the meaning. In such cases, usually acoustics can be challenging as the code-switched word may not be spoken with the native pronunciation. On the other hand, in alterational code-switching, the sentences are a combination of grammar from both the languages while adhering to constituent boundaries like phrases. In the example, I put the fork and en la masa are both valid phrases in their respective languages. Such cases can be challenging with respect to the language modeling aspect of speech recognition, as multiple grammars are being modeled. Acoustics could also be challenging if the speaker is not proficient in one of the languages. For our experiment, we used the SEAME Mandarin-English code switching corpora, which is among the largest and most used corpora for benchmarking code switched speech recognition. These models are typically evaluated using a metric called mixed error rate, which basically means that you would use character level edits for the Mandarin portion of the reference and the word level edits for the English portion of the reference. Now I will provide a quick summary of the contribution of our paper with respect to the challenges we just discussed. I will then discuss the transformer-transducer model and each of the proposed strategies to adapt this model towards code-switched speech recognition. In this work, we present training strategies and insights for improving transformer-transducer models towards code-switched speech recognition. In order to address the data sparsity issue, we extend the transformer-transducer model with two auxiliary loss functions, namely LM loss and CTC loss. To address the challenges in intra-sentential code switching, we propose language ID-aware mass training scheme. And finally, to leverage the abundance of monolingual data towards code switching, we propose a multilingual multi-label or multi-audio encoder framework for the transformer-transducer model. Okay, so transformer-transducers are a class of alignment-based model, just like the CTC or ASG-based models. However, unlike the CTC model, transducers condition the output on all of the previous labels. At the same time, unlike the attention-based encoder-decoder models, transducers learn explicit input-output alignment, which makes them robust towards long utterances. They also use the recently introduced transformers for their audio and label encoders, which allow superior modeling of long-term dependencies, which could be useful for code switching. Overall, our model looks like this. We have a label encoder, audio encoder, an alignment network, which consists of the joint network, the LM and CTC objectives are used as auxiliary loss functions for the label and audio encoder. We will discuss more about the objectives later. Okay, now that we have some context, let's start by discussing each strategy in detail, starting with addressing the data sparsity issue in code-switched speech recognition through CTC and LM joint training. The audio encoder of the transformer transducer learns frame-level audio representation, which is similar to the models that are trained using the CTC objective function. So we added the CTC loss as an auxiliary loss function to the transformer-transducer model, and we observe considerable gains, just like it has been shown for attention-based models, where the CTC objective can help learn better monotonic audio alignments. Similarly, the label encoder of the transformer-transducer learns to do next word prediction, just like a language model, using the LM objective as an auxiliary loss, helps stabilize and speed up our model training from almost 24 hours to 15 hours. Although this does not give improvement in the performance, the model output does seem grammatically coherent than before. Now we will discuss the LID-aware mass training, which we use to address the challenges in intra-sentential code switching. To recap, intra-sentential code switching can be challenging as ASR model needs to learn different alignments per language and also learn when to switch between languages during the next word prediction. We propose a token-level masking for label encoder, where we randomly mask target tokens with a mask tag. We hypothesize that this will help the model focus on learning audio alignments independent of the target token. By not relying on the entire history to predict the next word, we hope that the model becomes robust towards irregularities in utterances, like disfluency and non-speech sounds. This approach can be thought of as being analogous to back-off language models or ensembles of language models. Additionally, by adding language ID tags during the mass training process, we can improve our model further. We believe that this helps the label encoder learn the language switches within an utterance and inform the alignment network about the current language being aligned. Finally, we will discuss how we leverage the monolingual data towards code switching. In order to do this, we propose a multi-label or multi-audio encoder framework for code switch speech recognition. In this framework, we maintain individual audio and label encoders for each of the language present in the code switch data. The encoder can accept both the respective monolingual language as well as the code switch data. The information from the two encoders are combined using a learnable sigmoid gate. We see that the model improves considerably using this framework, and interestingly, the improvements of the multi-label framework is far greater than the improvements from the multi-audio framework. We think that this might be due to the difficulty in learning language boundaries in the acoustic space. Great, so let's see how everything goes together. So here we summarize the results of our proposed model with respect to some of the previous published models built for the SEAME code switch corpora. We can see that we significantly improve over the previously published transducer model without using any monolingual training data. Our model also performs considerably better than most attention-based encoder-decoder models on this dataset and comes close to the best one. We also see that monolingual data with the proposed multi-label encoder framework can improve the model further, giving us a mixed error rate of 18.5 and 26.3 on the two test sets of the SEAME corpora. So to recap, in this work, we present a transformer-transducer model for code-switched speech recognition. We propose modification to the vanilla transformer-transducer model in order to address the data sparsity and the intra-sentential nature of code switch data. We also propose a framework for incorporating monolingual data towards training models for code switch data. Finally, as part of future work, we hope to utilize the abundance of unsupervised data in order to help in code-switched speech recognition. Thanks everyone for listening. Please reach out to me if you have any additional questions. Thank you.